Running Llama 2 in machine learning pipelines poses significant challenges. How do we maintain a serverless approach, minimize service fees, use hardware accelerators, and ensure fast model download? What if we must scale the 7 billion parameter model all the way up to the 70 billion parameter model? In this video, we'll explore precisely that and show you how to effectively run Llama 2 in machine learning pipelines using the example of Vertex AI pipelines on Google Cloud. We'll be demonstrating the 7 billion parameter model today, but also discussing how to scale this up to 13 billion and even 70 billion parameters. Notably, as you increase the size, it becomes more effective to shift from ephemeral storage and dynamic model downloads to cloud storage for where we store the model before use. This model can then be used directly in Vertex AI pipelines. Now that we've outlined our goals, let's dive into the Google Cloud Console. As always, we'll share this diagram file along with all demonstration code in the video description below. The first thing you need to do if you're in a new project is to enable the Vertex AI APIs. We can do this by clicking the button that enables all the recommended APIs. With these APIs enabled, the next step is to create a run in our pipeline. We'll be using Python to define the pipeline within the Kubeflow framework. These are both open source and will enable pipeline execution on Vertex AI pipelines. While we could use any integrated development environment, this video will showcase the Google Cloud Shell IDE for writing our pipeline code. Let's first start by defining our pipeline, and then we'll outline the components needed inside that pipeline. Instead of hard coding the LLM prompt, let's allow the specification at pipeline runtime. For our pipeline construction, we need only a single task for querying our model, but keep in mind that you can easily add pipeline tasks before, after, or in parallel with this core task. An explicit CPU setting will be helpful here and will indirectly dictate how quickly we can download our model, since Google Cloud network bandwidth is generally coupled with core count. Let's say we set this to a handsome 8 CPUs. Pump up that CPU count, and you're also cruising in the fast lane of bandwidth. But wait, there's more. Next on our list is setting memory requests. Something along the lines of 16 gigabytes should be plenty. Remember when I mentioned adding accelerators? Let's take care of that by setting the accelerator limit to 1 and the accelerator type to T4. This is the secret ingredient in turbocharging the Llama models. You should match the model size with an appropriate accelerator setup. For example, consider an A100 GPU, or 2 if you want to use the 13 billion or even the 70 billion parameter models. Moving on, we'll set up the code that will compile our pipeline to an elegant and Vertex AI Pipelines compatible YAML file. Circling up to the task specification, we'll need to pick the perfect base image for our Kubeflow Pipelines component. This chosen image must have good GPU libraries and PyTorch support to nurture the Llama models that will be brought to life from these foundations. For this momentous task, we'll choose none other than the Hugging Face Transformers PyTorch GPU image. For Python package installs and overrides, we'll use the latest and greatest versions of the Accelerate library and Transformers library, since the Llama code can get pretty buggy with any older library versions. Since this model comes from Hugging Face and isn't exactly open source, we'll need a Hugging Face API token to log in with before the model pull. Hugging Face Hub effectively bridges the gap between our pipeline and the Llama model. We'll have to do some legwork to establish that bridge, though. From the Hugging Face website, get your hands on an access token. Also remember to head over to Meta's website and charm them into granting access to the Llama model. After clearing these hurdles, you're free to download the model from Hugging Face. Back in the setup, we're preparing our pipeline for chat text generation, allowing the library to automatically identify and use our GPUs. Then we're getting a model response based on adjustable model parameters like top K. We'll set the maximum response length and return the generated text as a string. It seems we have everything we need here, so let's try to compile this pipeline. Looks like we need to install the Kubeflow pipelines package first. Then let's save our pipeline file and try again with the latest changes. All right, we have an error here. This should be request and limit, not requests and limits. Now we've successfully compiled, which is a good start. Off screen, I'll add our secret Hugging Face token and recompile. For record keeping purposes, let's save this pipeline file to a cloud storage bucket. We could upload the file directly to Vertex AI Pipelines, but using a Google Cloud storage bucket offers cleanliness and organization. Be sure to authenticate with Google Cloud to copy over the pipeline file, regardless of the IDE you're using. Now we'll take the file from our cloud storage bucket and run it on Vertex AI Pipelines. The desired option in the interface is importing from cloud storage. We'll choose the same bucket for our output directory. For the prompt, we can specify any question. Let's submit and test our pipeline. If you encounter a task failure, check the logs. In our case, it seems we had a typo when spelling out transformers. After correcting it, we should recompile the pipeline and give it another try. Once the pipeline finishes, we can inspect the logs, where we'll see the model being downloaded and then utilized. In the task details, we see our output. Our answer is slightly chopped off because when we specify token limits, it does cut off somewhat abruptly. In any case, our Llama model has successfully run in the pipeline, marking a solid achievement for us. To recap, we've run this in a fully serverless way, downloaded the model quickly into the public cloud, ramped it up on CPUs to maximize throughput, and used an accelerator, all while keeping service fees relatively low. You can consult the Vertex AI pricing page for pricing details. But essentially, this pipeline only costs us 3 cents on top of the standard infrastructure pricing. As always, you can check the video description for diagram files and source code. Also, as a part of our AI tutorial series, we'll be making a donation of $1 for every 10 new subscribers to this video. Consider supporting the channel and the Center for AI Safety by subscribing or just donate directly. We hope this video has been helpful and want to thank you for watching. Please enjoy responsibly.